Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The boyfriend of Love Island star Sophie Graden, who committed suicide the day after her funeral, was taunted by trolls hours before his death. Aaron Armstrong, 25, was found dead at his home yesterday after it emerged he tried to take his own life 4 years ago. His family say they are devastated at the news, which comes just weeks after his girlfriend Sophie hanged herself. In the hours before his death, the boxer, from Blythe, Northumberland, revealed he was saved 4 years ago by his brother who found him. Aaron Armstrong, 25, was devastated by the death of his girlfriend, a former Miss GB, who is believed to have taken her own life aged 32. Aaron was responding to a bully on Instagram who accused him of attention-seeking. He responded, "I found her. I took my own life 4 years ago and got took down by my brother. You know nothing, you stupid F asterisk asterisk asterisking asterisk 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 asterisk. I make my choice like she did. I've been fighting this for 10 years. Go F asterisk 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 yourself. This post, I'm talking to her, not any of you. Scumbag people like you drive people to suicide. Hope you happy." Aaron Armstrong, 25, was devastated by the death of his girlfriend, a former Miss GB, at the age of 32. It was Aaron who discovered his girlfriend's body at her parents' home near Newcastle on June 22. Police are not treating the deaths as suspicious, suggesting they both took their own lives. Aaron Armstrong's father, David, 54, said from the large family home in Blythe, Northumberland, "We are devastated and Aaron was an amazing lad." His elder brother Ryan, 27, said, "All we can do is take one day at a time. It's been a very hard time. We'll make a statement at some point, but now isn't the right time." He said the family would be releasing a statement later in the week. Posting on social media in the days before his own death, Aaron made reference to seeing Sophie again, writing, "I will never stop loving you and my heart will be yours until the day I join you. I will see you very soon, my angel, so keep our sick bed warm for me." Sophie, who appeared on Love Island in 2016, had a secret battle with depression and was devastated when a close friend died recently. It appears Aaron had been unable to cope without her. Posting on social media in the run-up to his death, Aaron made reference to seeing Sophie again, writing, "I will never stop loving you and my heart will be yours until the day I join you. I will see you very soon, my angel, so keep a bed warm for me." Sophie's death, thought to be a suicide, garnered hundreds of tributes before she was laid to rest in her native Newcastle on Friday. Pictured, the couple together in Aaron's final post on Instagram, he said missed his girlfriend every day, adding, "I love you, princess." The family of current Love Island star Georgia Steele joined presenter Maya Jammer in mourning Aaron's tragic death. Posting to Georgia's Facebook account, her representatives wrote, "RIP to both angels," also asking her followers to be a little bit kinder every day. Maya told her followers to be careful how you treat people online and in real life, while adding that she was heartbroken by the news. A spokesperson for Northumbria Police said, at around 12:20 p.m. today, police received a report from the ambulance service that a 25-year-old man had been found deceased at a property on Furness Road in Bebside, Blythe. There is not believed to be any third-party involvement and a report will now be prepared for the coroner. Aaron had poured his heart out on social media since her death. He wrote, "I will never forget that smile. I love you, sir, so much, baby. You are my world forever, ever and always." Devastated friends took to social media to pay tribute to Aaron, pictured with Sophie. Today, after news of his death spread online, presenter Maya Jammer, the girlfriend of Stormzy, said she was also heartbroken to hear that Aaron has taken his life. Georgia Steele, who is currently on this year's version of Love Island, said she was absolutely heartbroken that Aaron took his own life. Sophie's death, thought to be a suicide, garnered hundreds of tributes before she was laid to rest in her native Newcastle on Friday. Friends, family and boyfriend Aaron gathered to say goodbye to beautiful Sophie. Devastated friends took to social media to pay tribute to Aaron today after news of his death spread online. Michael McCready posted on Facebook, "Very sad day today to find out that Aaron Armstrong has passed away. RIP Al, you're now with Sophie, sending my love and thoughts to all family and friends at this hard time." Friends, family and boyfriend Aaron gathered to say goodbye to beautiful Sophie at her funeral on Friday. Now Aaron has reportedly been found dead. Friends, family and boyfriend Aaron gathered to say goodbye to beautiful Sophie on Friday. pictured, Aaron posting about the funeral. Sophie, wearing her Miss Great Britain crown, is pictured in Covent Garden, London in 2009. Jill Sayer posted on Facebook, OMG, I'm in total shock, RIP Aaron Armstrong reunited in the sky. Caitlin Peachy posted on Twitter, can't even begin to imagine what Sophie Gradden and Aaron Armstrong's families must be going through. Two deaths on 2 week, RIP Aaron. Jessica Haley Marie posted on Twitter, absolutely heartbreaking news about Aaron Armstrong. I hope you and at Sophie Gradden are somewhere living it up together once again, RIP. Kay posted on Twitter, wow, RIP Aaron Armstrong, I hope you and Sophie fly high together, so sad to hear this. The inquest into Sophie's death was opened on June 27 during a very short hearing at North Tyneside Coroner's Court on June 27. It is believed Sophie was suffering from mental health problems at the hearing, which lasted less than a minute. The case was adjourned. It is believed Sophie, who appeared on ITV's reality TV show Love Island in 2016 and also worked as a model, had been struggling with mental health problems in the run-up to her death. During the hearing, Trevor Carroll, assistant coroner for South Northumberland, said, following initial inquiries, it is appropriate to open an inquest into her death. I will adjourn at this stage for further inquiries to determine cause of death. None of Sophie's friends or family was present at the hearing. Following her death, the owner of Tyne Tees Models, Leslie Lister, who scouted the star when she was just 16, said, despite her success, she was humble. It didn't matter what job she did for us, whether big or small, she approached it in the same way. She was also a great mentor to the younger girls. If any of them were having problems, she would take the time to talk to them and try and help. She would make people feel much better. Everyone absolutely loved her. She was a beautiful girl, but clever with it. I first spotted her on a night out when she was 16. I went over and spoke to her and she was gorgeous, very enthusiastic. Over the years, Sophie has juggled positions in marketing and recruitment with working as a model and reality TV star. Sophie was a star on ITV2's reality TV show Love Island. Before that, she was Miss Great Britain and a model. She became part of the Tyne Tees family and the rest is history. Sophie knew exactly what she wanted and went for it. We were all incredibly proud of what she achieved. She was our first ever Miss Newcastle and our first ever Miss Great Britain. Sophie attended the prestigious Dame Allen's School in Fenham, Newcastle, where fees are around £4,400 per term. She graduated from Northumbria University with a 2:1 in Media, Culture and Society in 2007. Over the years, Sophie has juggled positions in marketing and recruitment with working as a model and reality TV star. Dr. John Hind, principal of Dame Allen's Schools, paid tribute to Sophie after her death, saying, staff who recall Sophie remember her as a fun-loving, happy pupil who enlivened the schools, and we all regret her sad passing at such a young age.